So, year sevens, what we're going to do now is to create a more complex spreadsheet. And this one has some very good properties if you want to keep your secret secret. So, to really quickly talk you through what it does, we write the decimal numbers 0 all the way down to 31 here. And that means we can write out the entire alphabet, A through to Z, and also have six numbers 0 through to 5 at the end. This number is converted to binary. We do this by hand. And then we use that to encode all of our characters in binary numbers. So instead of writing H, H would become 00111. So down here in the keywords, let's enter keywords. This is what must be kept secret when you transfer this message. This gets translated, so the P gets translated into binary. So what it will do is go up here to P and realize that P is 01111, and that's what you get here. It does the same for A, S, W, and so on. So that's our keyword. That's not our ciphertext. That's what we use to unlock our ciphertext. The message here, we type in a secret message. And what's going on now is that the T gets converted to binary. So it looks up T down here and it knows 10011. But then what happens is the first eight here. So this is as gets compared to our keyword, and something happens to these binary numbers. It's called exclusive OR. So all of these binary numbers are compared with these binary numbers. And the result, which I'll explain in class, are these binary numbers. So T becomes 11100, which then gets looked up again. So 1110, sorry, 11100 is 28. So 28 gets looked up again, and the answer to that is the character 2. So if we take this one, for instance, S is 10010. This becomes 00000, which, of course, in binary is 0. So the S becomes A. But the well, two really good properties of this system is that it's very difficult to crack. So if we look at two characters which are the same, so S here, S becomes A, but the second time, S becomes 2. Here it's R. Here it's R again, but then it's 3. So this is very, very difficult to crack using something like frequency analysis. But the final really useful property is if we take our ciphertext here and we put this in, so 2H0A42RR, LCDWF, CVR3, AU, and W, what we get out is this is a secret message, our original message. So it's very difficult to crack, but it's also very easy to use. So don't do any of this just yet. What I would like you to do is to open up a blank Excel spreadsheet and to save it as, well, give it a sensible file name, whatever you'd like, but make sure you put it in the right folder. So it should be in your Year 7 folder. And then you're ready to start the next tutorial.